Tonight's film is a dramatization based on family experiences, interviews, court documents, and newspaper and magazine accounts.
You want to go? Oh, come on, Gene. It's a nice social event. Good food, some laughs. You can use some laughs, right?
Can't tomorrow. It's a big day. Andrew competes in the regionals in Indianapolis.
Regionals?
Roller skating. You should see her. She's amazing. I don't know where she gets the talent. Not from me.
All right. What about Sunday? I'll check my schedule. Maybe I can make myself available.
I can't. Steve's taking us to the movies.
I thought you two were divorced.
We're still friends.
Well, I'm your friend, too. Let me see. What about Monday? Or do you got a date with your first husband for Monday?
Monday, I got to take Ryan to the doctor.
Not at night.
Yay, it's a night doctor.
Seriously, Gene, I'm going to give up on you. You keep turning me down.
Money's no good, but don't give up on me.
Hey, how's Ryan doing?
Oh, he's real good, thanks. Hey, Holly.
Yeah, I'm a nice
real
guy.
Good.
Tell her I'm a nice guy, Roberta.
Gonna go out with him? He's funny. He's sexy.
What do you think? Up or down?
Sure, it's the pits. It's terrible.
It does? Does.
How about this one?
Come on, let's go. I can't be late. I hate that shirt. It makes you look so skinny. Here, put this one on. You look good in this.
I don't feel good in it.
Problem's not the shirt. It's your face.
Ryan, stop! You get a bleed and I go on at six. Stop it! Stop it now! So that's where they went. Next time use your own, okay? Come on. Come on, Heath. Now put this one on. You look good in this.
I gotta comb my hair.
Don't be a brat.
I gotta comb my hair.
Ryan!
Coming.
Come on, you're keeping Andrea waiting.
Hey, your hair looks great.
Get in the car.
What happens if you win the regionals? Do you go on the nationals?
Yep.
Do you have to beat Tammy to win?
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, that girl's good.
Stop making her nervous. Hey, leave her alone. I said leave her alone.
Mom, you're gonna mess up my hair.
Oh, don't mess up her hair, God.
Mom, I need some new shirts.
What do you need new shirts
well,
for?
Don't you get it? He has a girlfriend.
Shut up,
hey, don't hit her in the head. Watch her. Hey, hey, you two be nice to each other. What? Brian, who is she?
Sue Hatch, and she's so stuck. Oh.
Shut up.
Stop it.
Come on. She's nice. Mom, I have to get my axle clean or I will never be Tammy.
Andrea, stop worrying.
Road skating is so boring.
Totally.
Hi, Ryan.
Hi, Sue.
Oh, look,
don't you know where Andrea is? Today, when she comes on.
Okay. Now contestant number 12, Andrea White.
You little twerp.
Shut up!
You okay?
Yeah.
Honest, Jeannie, it's not my fault.
It's my fault. I gotta bleed this.
You've been roughhousing with Heath.
No!
Some factor. There you go. go. Now, it's gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt for a couple more hours, so you gotta take it easy.
I've been real tired all day.
It's burning up. Honey, you're burning up.
I don't feel so good.
Lie down. Okay, go on. Just lay right down. Watch your ankle. Watch your ankle. Still 104. I'm taking you to the hospital.
I don't feel that bad. I just can't breathe.
Honey, you got 104 fever. Dr. Field said if you got up to 104, take you to the hospital.
Oh.
Ryan, we gotta go.
Dr. Powell, please call main information. Dr. Powell, please call main information.
Is it with the wife?
What's going on?
They want to operate.
Why?
They need to take a biopsy of his lung.
What's a biopsy?
Well, they cut him open, take out a piece of his lung to find out what kind of pneumonia he's got.
Let him do it, Mom.
I have to. I just have to, Andrea. They say if I don't, in the next 24 hours, he may be so weak that they may not be able to operate at all.
Respiratory therapy, call ICU stat. Respiratory therapy, call ICU stat.
Tough little guy.
We'll take good care of him. Out so you don't feel any pain. No pain, Ryan. Probably a prayer. All right. Please keep him safe and be with him during the operation. Amen.
Amen.
What about Christmas?
Don't worry. I get Christmas presents, whether it be here or at home.
Love you.
I love you too.
Dr. Copeland, pick up extension 12. Dr. Copeland, pick up extension 12.
Called your father. Told him they're operating on Ryan.
He's not coming, right?
Right. I'll call him later with the results.
Why? He doesn't care.
Mrs. White, Dr. Kleiman would like to see you in the nurse's lounge.
Okay.
Mrs. Johnson, report to fifth floor OR. Mrs. Johnson, report to fifth floor OR.
Mrs. White, I'm Dr. Kleiman.
Hi. This is Andrea, Ryan's sister.
Hi.
Hi.
Ryan's doing okay.
Oh.
And I want to tell you what we found out so far. Ryan has type of infection that normal children just don't get. It's called pneumocystis. Since we know he has it, and since we also know that he's been getting blood products for a long time to treat his hemophilia, our major consideration is that a virus has severely damaged his immune system. Mrs. White, Ryan has AIDS. For me to be able to tell you how much time Ryan has, but he's going to get better from the pneumonia because we know how to treat it. We need more information, but he's not going to die from this pneumonia. I'm confident of that.
If Ryan's gonna die, we're all gonna die together. We're gonna take him home. We're gonna pull into the garage, close the door, and let the car run until we all fall asleep.
Kill ourselves? Mom, Grandma, and Grandpa are here.
How's Ryan taking it?
He doesn't know yet, and I don't want him to. Not until he's ready to come home, or at least until after Christmas. Could be our last one. I want it to be special.
How long has he got?
Dr. Kleinman won't say it, but the truth is 3 to 6 months.
Oh, my God.
Can we see him?
Mm-hmm. I just want you to be as normal as possible so he doesn't worry. Dad, it's okay.
I just don't understand. All the kids in the world, why Ryan?
Homosexuals started this disease.
Mom, nobody knows who started it.
Oh, no? The newspapers said...
Don't blame homosexuals. If you want to blame anybody, blame me.
Jean.
I'm the one who carried the deformed gene that gave Ryan the hemophilia. I'm the one who gave Ryan the shots for the hemophilia.
Stop.
And that's how he got the bad blood product, and that's how he got AIDS. So
Evie.
If you want to put it on anybody, you put it on me.
I am not putting anything on anybody.
Come on, come on. Let's get going.
Just remember as normal as possible, okay?
Well, Mom, Dad, look, he's doing so much better. Hope to get him off the respirator in a few days.
That's great.
By Christmas? I hope so.
Dog.
What?
He wants a dog.
Oh, I don't know.
Can he have a dog?
Oh, Brian, I don't know. Animals carry disease just like humans. You could catch something from it. Ask Dr. K. I can't do... All right, where is he? Is he around?
Yeah, he's right down the hall.
All right, I'll go see what he Fine. No Herbie. I told you I'm not bringing him to the hospital against rules. That's it. It's final, finished. Mom, come on. Come help me talk to Dr. K.
Who's Herbie?
This is Herbie. Here you go.
Here.
Micah?
No, you better not ever let Dr. Kleiman say that.
Micah?
Tapes.
Ryan's computer. I bought him a computer.
Mom, what would they want my skating tapes for?
I can't believe it. He would have loved it.
Mom, why would they want my skating tapes?
Andrea, I don't know what they want with your skating tapes. I don't know why anybody would do this to us.
Come on, Ryan. It's Dr. Kleiman's orders.
Call him. We made a deal.
Oh, you two have a secret little pact, huh?
Yeah, that's why I call him Dr. K and he calls me RW.
All right, well, why don't you just have, look at one little bite.
No.
It's good for you, Ryan.
I don't want any.
You don't want any of this stuff. Well, what do you want?
Nothing.
Do you want a Christmas present?
Wow. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Yeah. John Cougar.
You know the authority song?
I find authority, authority always wins. Well, I find authority, authority always wins. Well, I've been doing it since I was a young kid and I come out grinning. Well, I find authority, authority.
No! Oh, come on, Ryan. It's not funny. It's not funny. All right. Suit yourself. I thought you wanted to get better, though. You know, when you smile, you're kind of cute.
Mm-hmm. asked Reverend Williams to come today because we have something to talk to you about, and,
Will you pray with me, Ryan?
Pray?
Lord, be with us here today as we stand before the wonderful and awesome mystery of thy will and thy love. Be with Ryan and Jeannie now as they seek to understand what has happened and to accept what lies ahead. Amen.
Amen.
Accept what? Accept what?
You remember why they had to operate?
Yeah, because they wanted to find out what kind of pneumonia I had, right?
It's a rare form called pneumocystis. It's a very rare kind of pneumonia. And only people who... The only people who get it are people whose immune systems are weak. People who have...
Ryan. Honey. Honey, you have AIDS.
Does Laura know?
Laura, the nurse?
Yeah.
She knows.
Am I gonna die?
Someday, we just don't know when.
Double Mapes clean. Now that's what I have to do with an ash.
Sorry, honey, I missed it. I hate these pamphlets. They don't tell you anything. In here, the doctors say one thing, and here they say something else. There's one thing they seem to agree on. You can't get AIDS by living in the same house, drinking from the same glass, or kissing.
Well, then we don't have anything to worry about.
Come on, Andrea!
Just a minute. He'll get better, I know he will.
No one knows, Andrea. None of the experts know.
Yeah, well, I know.
You, remember that night in the car when I talked about the garage and closing the door? Let's just forget about it.
Forget about what?
Our lives are very valuable. Yours and Ryan's and mine. It was a stupid thought. Very selfish. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
That's my girl. And let me see that double flip and lift.
It's double makes mine.
Double makes me.
Thanks a lot. Come on, come on. I'll call you. Call you. I'm gonna call him Barney. What do you think about Barney for a name?
It's your dog.
Yeah.
Look out, Roy. Look out. Here, come on in the kitchen. I want to talk to you about school.
So when am I going back? Tomorrow?
Ryan, they don't want you to go back.
What?
They say you're too sick.
I can't go back to school?
That's what they say.
That's crazy! I can ride bikes! I can go to the movies! I've got my own paper route! I can do everything, but I can't go to school?
No.
I got to. I already have to take the seventh grade over
again. You can't.
I am.
They say no.
Who says no?
Mr. Colby, the principal, Mr. Smith, the superintendent of schools, they're afraid.
Afraid of what?
AIDS.
But nobody can get it. Not by me just going to school.
I know that.
Then tell me.
I have. I just came from the school. They won't listen. They're afraid to take a chance. They say it's a communicable disease.
Well, how am I supposed to learn anything if I can't go to school? Well, what do they want me to do? Sit around here and do nothing? What am I gonna do?
They don't want you back.
Just through here.
Thank you.
Did you have any trouble finding it?
No, it was fine.
Good. It's just down the hall and to the left.
So you're Mr. Vaughn's son?
Mm-hmm.
How are you?
That's right. The woman you met up front was my sister.
She's pretty.
Yes, she is. Right through here.
Well, her mouth is cut up something fierce and you're going to ruin her. She is not ornery. You just don't know how to handle her. Bull. Nothing wrong with that bit. It's you. Damn it, man. Don't argue with me. Just do what I tell you to do. Be Gerald. You understand me? All right.
Dad, this is Jeannie and Ryan White.
Hello, Mr. Vaughn.
Tell me what the problem is.
Well, as I told you on the phone, Mr. Smith, the superintendent of schools, told me that Ryan couldn't come back. And when I called him to argue, he cut me off saying there was no need for us to fight or try and hire a lawyer because we didn't have any money.
Told you you couldn't fight it because you didn't have any money.
That's what he said.
Well, most kids would think this was a great day, not having to go to school. You really sure you want to go to school?
I like school. I don't have anything else.
He doesn't do sports. He likes sports, but he can't do them. School's his thing. He loves being at school with his friends. But the superintendent's right. I don't have any money.
Well, Miss White, when you practice law, sometimes your clients have money, sometimes they don't.
You'll take Ryan's case?
Yes. Now then, let's let Mr. Smith take a good holt, as Sam Snead used to say, because we're going to try to teach him a little lesson.
Look, Doctor, my daughter goes to school here, and last year the white kid had a nosebleed, and she helped him out. Now, is there any guarantee that she's not going to get AIDS, too?
That's just not available.
Well, then he shouldn't be in school.
What we do know about the AIDS virus is that it lives in the bloodstream. It's communicable through the mucous membranes, the eyes, the mouth, the intestinal tract, and the sexual organs. It can pass through a cut in the skin, but you can't get it by touching the same objects or being in the same room.
Oh, yeah? Then why did the cops in Indianapolis wear gloves when they busted that adult bookstore? Now, you don't know, do you?
Nobody knows, but I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to start a petition to keep Ryan White out of this school.
And I'll sign it. I don't want my kid coming to this school.
I'll sign it.
Yeah, me too. Please, let's do this in a rational manner. As a principal, I can tell you that I'm doing everything prudent at this time to protect everybody's interests.
I don't think you're doing enough.
Neither do I. Let me ask you this. Do you have kids?
Do I? Yes.
Well, then, I don't understand how you cannot be worried. Who's going to help me out?
We will. We're going to help.
Hey, Heath, how you doing?
Hey, Tommy. Congratulations. Heard you got a D in English. So, how you doing?
Fine.
Want to play splits?
I don't really like knives.
This is a great knife. This is an army knife. It's really sharp.
I got to fold these papers for Ryan today. I'm doing a route.
Oh, where is he?
Inside.
Is he sick?
So he says.
Oh, God,
are you okay?
Yeah. Oh, it's very good.
You jerk!
Jake.
Hi, how you doing? Come on in. What can I do for you?
I want another paper.
What's the matter?
Mine had blood on it. I don't think it's very funny.
I'm sorry, I don't understand. What are you talking about?
I got blood all over my paper.
Are you sure it's blood? Let me see.
Oh, no. I'm keeping it as evidence.
Just a minute. Now, I don't know how it got there, and I'll give you another paper. Just hang up. Here. And just so you know, Andrea and Heath did the route today.
Well, somebody bled on my paper. Who knows what could happen to me?
Andrea? Andrea, come here. How'd blood get on a paper?
It must have been the vampire bloody Heath we were kind of fooling around before.
How could you do that knowing how everybody feels?
We didn't do it on purpose, Mom.
That's all we need. That's just all we need.
So we looked up and found that in the state of Indiana, no kid has a constitutional right to an education.
How can that be?
It just is. That's why we're coming to federal court. See, state law is no good for us. So Charlie Jr. and I researched federal law. We found that handicapped children have a right to a free public education everywhere.
Now you understand why we're going to a federal court.
But Ryan's not handicapped.
Well, if his life needs can't be met, he qualifies as handicapped. The school would have to give him a free
appropriate education. This is the way we gotta go.
Well, buddy, there they are.
Oh, my God.
Mr. Bond, why are you even here today?
Right. Please tell us why you're not satisfied.
Mr. Bond, why did you take this case?
Is this disease transmittable?
Your Honor, we do not think that Ryan's admission in school at this time is in the best interests of the other students and the staff of Western School Corporation. And further, we cannot believe Ryan's emotional health under the circumstances of this case will be helped by placement in the normal classroom.
Your Honor, this is an emergency. Ryan White has AIDS. It's clear medical research has found AIDS is not transmitted through casual contact. If we have to exhaust all these administrative remedies, the boy may not be living by the time we get through it all. Now, for the time he has left, Ryan should be entitled to go to school.
Mr. Day?
In Indiana, we have a process for a handicapped child to go through in order to determine his or her educational placement. Now, that process, pursuant to the Education for All Handicapped Children Act, is a four-tiered administrative procedure that every handicapped child must go through. Emergency or not, this procedure has to be followed. It's the law.
I've listened to both sides. And I'll take the matter under advisement. I'll let you know my decision in the very near future.
So when's he gonna make up his mind? School starts in 2 weeks.
I don't know. I have a feeling he's not very happy about having to make this decision.
This judge is a wimp.
He's just trying to do his job.
Russell, what'd you hear about my insurance?
Jeannie, I've got Detroit working on it. Believe me, we're all trying to help.
Oh, that's great. Well, how long is it going to take? See, because my bills are mounting up, and for having to take so many days off, I haven't been able to pay them.
There's not much about AIDS in the medical plan.
Well, I know
I'll let
that,
you know as soon as I find something out.
Okay, that would
Ryan,
be really
cute. Okay?
Yeah, Ryan's fine. Thanks. Well, he's not. He's okay, but, look, thanks for asking.
What did he say?
Not at all.
Hi, Jeannie. How's Ryan doing?
Oh, he's okay.
Said a prayer for him at church.
Thanks.
How's it going?
Hanging in.
You know, Jean, there's a lot of scared people in here.
Scared of what?
You?
Well, they can't catch nothing from me.
I know that.
What are they saying? You want cream?
No, I'm glad. What a jerk.
What'd you say, man?
You heard what I said.
Hey, she shouldn't even be in here.
Oh.
I don't have AIDS. You can't catch it from me.
Oh, yeah, how do you know?
Because I know.
Yeah, well, you might not have it now, but I heard it like 7 years. I mean, you shouldn't even be touching this stuff. Coffee pot or putting your...
You shouldn't be touching me, man.
Oh, yeah, and who are you pushing, huh? Who do you think you're pushing?
Harley, come on.
You have no idea. You have no idea what you're talking about. None.
Yeah, and you're a real brain surgeon yourself.
Let it go.
Anytime, man.
Anytime what? Guys like that, I like to... I mean, you see that?
Yeah, some of the girls are getting panicky, too.
That's crazy. Why?
Well, Betty and Linda said they won't use the washroom if you do.
Oh, yeah? Well, they better get over it, because... because I don't know how they're going to get through the whole week without using the John. You okay?
Thanks a lot. That was great. I'll talk to you later.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hold on, I'll walk with you. Well, what are you doing Tuesday?
Why did you bet?
Wednesday.
Thanks. Have a nice day. Hey, I just got two officers.
That's wonderful. We just got another house with two more signatures.
Oh, that's terrific.
Ryan's my paper boy. You mean you can get this from a paper?
Nobody knows how you can get it. Sign.
Wait, what is this? Your sign?
Is that dog bite?
Only if she's hungry. What is this?
It's a petition to keep Ryan White out of school.
I know him. I'll sign it. Look, the way kids are, anything could happen in school. I mean, you know, they're always sharing the same food and chewing on their pencils.
Ryan's 13, and teenagers don't do that kind of thing.
Kids don't chew pencils. Even adults chew pencils.
Well, maybe you do, Missy, but maybe you got an oral fixation.
I'm very serious. He's a danger to those kids in school.
Let me ask you something. You suddenly have kids in junior high with him?
Me? No. I have one in kindergarten. My little one hasn't started yet.
So what are you leading the petition for?
Look, I have nothing personal against Ryan White. I'm a concerned citizen. Sign it for your son's sake until we know more. We just have to be careful.
I really need your support on this.
The federal judge refused to order the Western School Corporation to readmit the 13-year-old AIDS victim until he has exhausted all administrative procedures. The White's attorney, Charles Vaughn...
Why didn't you tell me?
Meanwhile, the community has...
We lost, didn't we? Not lost, exactly.
What then?
Just kind of delayed.
Why?
Because they're real determined to keep you out. And Mr. Vaughn says that they could drag on these proceedings as long as possible because...
They think I'll die, right? Well, they better not hold their breath.
Ryan.
You should have told me!
At school. Our life's a mess.
But it's not your fault.
I gave you the hemophilia.
Mom, give me life.
Just say you forgive me.
Mom, don't. Just don't.
I'm sorry, Ryan.
Stop.
I'm so sorry.
Mom, stop!
Mom, what about skiing tonight?
This is so much work. I gotta work overtime whenever I get a chance.
There's a swarm of reporters out there.
Why don't you skate at the open skating at the rink tonight?
It's not practice.
Ryan, you get ready for school.
I'm ready.
Sorry, I'm one.
Ryan, I told him just one of them could interview you. This is a...
Jennifer Taylor, Nightside News, Indianapolis. Hi, Ryan.
Won't we do it in the living room?
Sure,
just, wherever you say.
Honey, you sit in the rocker. I'll bring a chair. Just
okay.
Right, yeah. Here? Yeah. You do it.
Oh,
she's
so
excited. Ryan, we'll just have a little chat.
Are you going to be a star? Never.
Is Ryan going to be interviewed for TV?
I don't know. My brother said your brother's a faggot.
He is not. Shut up.
Such an idiot.
Ryan, a lot of people are wondering why you're doing this, taking on the school system. If you're really so sick, why do you even want to go to school?
I like school. I like to be with my friends.
But do you like all this publicity?
I just want everybody to leave us alone.
You know they won't, Ryan. You're a big story.
I guess.
Jeannie, do you and Ryan use the same toothpaste?
Yeah, why wouldn't we?
Well, aren't you afraid of catching AIDS?
No, I don't worry about it.
Have you been tested?
Yes.
Do you have it?
No. And Andrea's been tested, too. No family members ever contracted AIDS.
So you're not worried about catching AIDS at all?
If it was contagious, I'd have it. If you could get it by airborne, then I'd have had it, but it's not.
Mrs. White? Mrs. White?
Could you just give us a minute? Please, you don't mind. Thank you. All this attention must be nerve-wracking, huh, Ryan?
Doesn't bother me.
What does bother you, Ryan?
Things I heard people saying. Like that I spit on vegetables in the supermarket. Especially when they say, we know how you really got it.
What do you mean?
People think I'm gay.
Really?
Gays aren't the only people who get it.
Rhea?
Here.
Mark?
Here.
Joey?
Oh, here.
Sue?
Here.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Open your books, please, to page 219, and let's get started. We're going to be talking about the First, Second, and Third Crusades. Now, Ryan isn't with us today, and we all know why Ryan isn't here, right?
Right. Yes.
Yes. He can hear what we're saying in this little speaker box, and we'll be able to hear him.
Hi, Ryan. How you doing?
Hey, Ryan.
How are you, Ryan?
Andy, where have you been? We'll talk about it later. Just sit down. Just go sit down. Hey, sit, Andy. Sit. Okay. Hello, Ryan. Hello. Hi. Hello, Ryan. Are you there?
Hi.
Okay, let's say hello to Ryan. Can we do that?
Hello, Ryan.
Ryan, did you hear us?
Hi.
Let's try it again. Real loud this time.
Hello, Ryan.
Hello.
Ryan? Ryan.
There he is.
Hello.
Ryan, please speak into the speakerphone. Joey, wait, Joey, thank you.
Ryan.
Hi.
Ryan, are you there? Wait, guys. Thank you very much. Can we start reading on the First Crusade, please?
Hello?
Ryan, can you...
Go away.
Ryan,
please
speak into the speaker. Ryan.
Go away.
Ryan, speak directly into the speaker.
I am.
Come on, Ryan. Ryan, how can you...
Boom.
This is WWKI Kokomo, and you're listening to Mail Call.
Good morning.
Good morning. Does anybody know if you can catch AIDS from casual contact?
Hey, Jane. Pretty sexy sneakers you got there.
Same question. Can you catch it by casual contact? And one said absolutely not. And the next person, you know what he said? We don't really know you. We don't think you can. And I said, wait a minute now, sir. Don't think so is not good enough for the life of my children. Don't think so? So you're going to say it's okay for a boy who's got AIDS to be in public school with 1,000 other kids because right now you don't think so? With an incubation period of up to 7 years, where will you be in 7 years, sir, when my child comes down with AIDS? And he stuttered and stammered around and said, well, all I can tell you is we don't think so.
We don't think so.
Homo, queer.
Just ignore him.
Maybe I should offer to shake their hands.
Hey, Mom, can I still go skating tonight?
I told you yes, Andrea.
I'm not. I'm doing my homework with Sue at her house.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Well, what time do you have to be at Sue?
7. Dead.
Joe, could you help?
Right, sure. Just wait here a second.
Hey, Don, you got any jumper cables you could help me?
No, we don't.
Sorry, Jeannie.
Does anybody have any jumper cables that can help me out here?
All right, just give me my purse, will you? Andrea, you guys wait here. I'm going to go inside. I'm going to call Grandma, see if we can borrow her car. We'll get there, Andrea. I promise you, we'll get there.
Got it, Mom. Am I early?
No.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
What's the matter?
Ryan, my mom thinks it would be better if we didn't study together anymore.
Okay.
Ryan, I'm sorry.
I'm right here.
Promise me something.
What is it, sweetheart?
When I die, just don't bury me in Kokomo. Mom.
I'm scared.
get some comics?
All the way upstairs.
We'll take the elevator.
That's a real pain.
Did the doctor say you had to stay in bed?
No, we don't have a lot of energy.
I don't have a lot of energy either. But don't you hate being stuck in this room?
Yeah, I don't feel so good.
Green Lantern. Spider-Man. Come on. Come on, Chad.
All right. You ought to get one of these.
No way. What for?
You don't have to eat anything.
I like to eat.
I've got these sores in my throat, though, and it hurts whenever I swallow.
Yeah, well, I throw up all the time, but I'd rather eat than have tubes.
Yeah, but with these tubes, you don't have to eat or throw up.
No pain, no gain.
For you to say, you don't know how I feel.
Hey, I have AIDS too, remember? Everything you've got.
Like tumors?
I don't hear you coughing all the time. Just in the elevator. Hey.
Girlfriend did when she found out?
Yeah. A girl dumped me too. But that's no reason to give up.
It's just nobody knows what it feels like to be all alone. You know?
Amy, you have AIDS. I would like you to tell this court how you would feel if you applied to go to school and were told that you could not enter because you had AIDS.
I object to the question to the extent that it mischaracterizes the testimony. I have no objection to her telling us what it would feel like to be barred from school.
What is the mischaracterization?
You have no objection to her answer, but you object to the question?
I object to the question. I thought it suggested Ryan White was barred from school simply because he has AIDS. Which is not the evidence in this case.
Well, that was our understanding, that he couldn't go back because he had AIDS.
You haven't followed the case.
We will strike that portion of the question from the question so that she can answer.
Let's state for the record, then. I would like this statement in the record that Ryan White was not barred from the classroom because he has AIDS. And then we're going to dismiss. We're going to walk right out of here.
Mr. Vaughn, you just said that Ryan White was barred from the classroom.
I would just like to get it clear whether or not Ryan was barred because he has AIDS. If Mr. Day is serious that he wasn't barred on August of 1985, then I think we should get it clear for the record, because that was the notification to Jeannie White that he couldn't go to school because he has AIDS. That was his notification from Mr. Smith.
Mr. Vaughn, please be seated. We're going to have a 5-minute recess.
What's going on? I can't follow this. I don't even understand what you're talking about. If they're barring him from school not because he has AIDS, why are they barring him?
This hearing isn't about AIDS. It's a hearing to determine whether or not Ryan is handicapped. You remember I said that was the way we had to go?
Yeah, so why are you talking about AIDS?
Because AIDS is why he qualifies to be handicapped.
This is very confusing.
No way! I'm not getting a feeding tube!
It's a small incision and it's not painful.
Yeah,
it'll be completely covered up. It will be. It'll be under your shirt. No one will see it. And it's temporary.
Yeah, temporary.
When you no longer need it, we'll remove it. Honest. Really.
I'm not getting a feeding tube!
Ryan, this is not negotiable. You have to have it.
Chad.
Stop comparing yourself to Chad. You're two different human beings. Ryan, you have to have it.
There you are. I just came from court. We got through the process that they said you couldn't get through. You qualified as handicapped. You can go back to school.
When?
As soon as you're better.
Good news. Congratulations.
That's great. Let's do it.
Parents have the right under Indiana law to have their children attend schools which are free from communicable diseases. Not only AIDS, but also measles, mumps, chickenpox, tuberculosis, meningitis, etc.
They're not the same.
AIDS patients are known to be susceptible, and any of which Ryan White could carry to school undetected.
I thought we won. Never really won?
I told you they would appeal.
So we won, but we lost. As soon as we won, we lost.
Now we're going to deal with the big issue. Their appeal will be about Ryan having AIDS.
Well, why don't they believe what the doctors say?
Jeannie, relax.
I can't. I'm sorry. I just can't take it anymore. You don't know what it's like. Living every day. All day. Every day. People just whispering and staring and hating me.
I know how it is.
You don't! You can't! You can't! You can't! Oh. Sorry. Oh, Mr. Vaughn, I'm real sorry. Maybe it'd just be better if we kept Ryan at home and forget fighting it because we can't win.
We can win.
Even if he does win. By some miracle. What's it going to be like for him if he goes back to school?
When he goes back.
People are so crazy. Anything could happen.
Let's just quit. Okay.
That how you feel, Ryan? You want to quit?
No.
You do want to go back to school.
Yes, I have to. I need it.
All right. And I don't represent you anymore, Jeannie. I only represent Ryan here.
Ryan? Ryan?
School.
Don't want to be a man. You
WWKI, Kokomo, and you're listening to Mail Call.
They got him for attempted murder.
Attempted murder?
Attempted murder. He's got AIDS, and he spit on someone.
Wow. Didn't know what kind of power those boys have.
We got a big article in the Indianapolis Star here a while back that the boy attended a Pacers game or a Colts game. It was just like the family said, ha ha. We went to the game and sat right beside you, and you didn't even know it.
This is WWKI Kokomo, and you're listening to Mail Call.
Good morning.
Good morning. You know, a mother like that, taking her son out in public like that, with people all around, I mean, obviously she doesn't care about us. But doesn't she care about him? Doesn't she love her own boy?
I don't think so. Good morning.
You got no right to talk about my mother. She's a great person, and she does love me. You've got no right. No right.
What a boy.
And a boy!
Here she comes. Andrea, honey, I just want to ask you a question.
Don't have anything to say.
How are things at home?
Will you please leave me alone?
Fix my skateboard.
Next time, don't use it, okay? Because you never put anything back.
Well, you're the sloppy one. The one who always loses things.
That's because you're always taking everything.
I never took your earphones. They're in your room.
But what were you doing in my room?
You're always in my room.
Hi.
Are we still going skating tonight?
I'm sorry, honey. I gotta go talk to Mr. Vaughn tonight.
Talk about Ryan's appeal, right?
Peel. Andrea, what is the matter?
Nothing.
Andrea, what is the matter?
Go be with Ryan.
Andrea, come back out here.
What?
Quit being a brat.
Shut up.
You shut up.
Both of you shut up. Now, what is wrong?
Ryan White. I'm sick of hearing Ryan White. Our whole world is Ryan White.
Ryan's party's been hit by a car.
What?
I'm sorry, he ran right out.
No, don't touch him.
I tried to stop, but he ran right out in front of me. I really tried.
It pleased the court, in point of simple fact, the only evidence, after months of testimony, is that Ryan constitutes no danger to his fellow students whatsoever.
Your Honor, communicable disease is defined by statute, and as long as the child has a communicable disease, the person having custody shall not permit said child to attend school. Shall not. It's mandatory, no excuses, it's the law.
Your Honor?
Mr. Vaughn.
It's a 1949 statute, and I suggest that in 1949, there was no concern about AIDS, since the disease did not exist. Furthermore, if you look beyond the single paragraph he's quoting, it says that a health officer and a physician can permit the child to enter the classroom.
A point of order. It's true, Your Honor, the law is 37 years old, but it hasn't been repealed. And it's not my job, nor Mr. Vaughn's job, to question the intent of the legislature.
they pick out one isolated, antiquated law, and they say this is it. It says, shall not, and that's it for all eternity. Then they stick their heads in the sand, and they say you can't look at any other law.
Well, I appreciate the comments, counsel. The court is not insensitive to Ryan White or his mother and their needs. The court is also not in a vacuum or unaware of how disruptive this case has been. I think it's unfortunate, as Mr. Vaughn says, that we're dealing here with an antiquated statute. However, when you read the law, it is unclear, in light of 1986 problems, what was intended and what the practice should be here today. Therefore, I'm going to grant the temporary restraining order.
We've won! We've won!
Look at these people. They think this is some kind of basketball game.
No, it's not over yet. It's just another round.
Mr. Vaughn, are you
ever dreamed that they would use that 1949 statute?
Are you going to appeal? Kokomo. That's why Mr. Vaughn's getting the venue changed, and we could lose in another city.
Even if we did lose, we could always appeal.
And that could take years.
What am I gonna do?
What do you want? What do you want?
You know what I want.
What do you want?
You know what I want, Mommy.
You want to go to school?
Yes. I want to go to school.
Then you will. Damn it. You will.
Then I can go back to school. And if he doesn't?
If he doesn't, well.
All rise. Court is now in session. Please be seated. Gentlemen, you can read the written order. In the interest of brevity, I will simply say that the temporary restraining order is dissolved.
We won! This is amazing!
good. You were there.
So that's all there is to it?
That's it. That's all there is to it. What are you going to do now?
I'm going to school.
Okay, everybody out of the car. It's a celebration. Party. Why don't you call it?
Okay. Tammy come too?
Bet. Might even invite some friends over.
Carly, the one from the factory.
Who told you about him?
You like him, don't you? Invite him over, Mom.
Well, did he call?
Huh?
I asked you, did he call?
Mom, come here. What is it? What if we were home?
That's why they did it. Because we were.
Scared, Mom.
All right, don't worry.
They hate us. They hate us here. They're gonna try to kill us next.
Andrea, get in the
now
house.
Ryan's going back to school, just gonna make it worse.
Andrea, just get in the
house. House to me the creeps, Mom.
Andrea, Ryan, please get in the house. Please stop looking at
me. Kokomo.
Come on, get in the house, please.
Contact.
Yeah, that's been explained.
I'm sorry. Well, how do you feel about it?
Karen, you are not staying for another minute.
All right.
What happened last night?
Ryan. Ryan.
Hi. Ryan.
Ryan. Welcome back.
Are you glad to see you?
Ryan, you just, excuse me, we're leaving.
No press inside. No press inside, please. All right, people, let's go. School time.
Hey,
come on, nothing to see here. Let's go break it up.
Come on,
we're leaving.
John, come on. Good morning, Ryan.
Morning, Mr. Smith.
Ryan!
Are you ready for today?
Don't worry, Mr. Colby. I know what we agreed to.
Thanks.
Hey.
Getting out of here.
How's it going?
So, what'd you agree on?
Well, I have my own private John in the back, and it's the only one I can use.
That's messed up. It's a
fist. Yeah. And then in the cafeteria, I have paper plates and plastic forks and spoons, and I have to throw them all away when I'm done. And I can't use any of the fountains.
What happens if you get thirsty?
Staying in school as long as that kid is here.
Phew, it's a long trip to Indianapolis and back.
Oh, I don't mind, honey.
I just wish I could take you every time you needed to practice.
Can't take me there enough times to make it worthwhile.
Andrea, Grandpa doesn't mean to complain.
I know, but I don't have the time to get in all the practice that I need to have to be good. I know if I go to the Nationals next year, I'll just be beat. So I'm gonna put off skating for now. Because the guys are just too busy.
Oh, honey. Come on. That's an awful lot to give up.
Maybe it'll just be for a little while.
Mm-hmm. You're giving up skating? I'm not giving it up. I'm just gonna practice when I have a chance. Hate it here.
She's still having those nightmares?
Ever since the bullet hole, she's been really scared.
Okay. Hey, everybody, get in the car. Let's go. Where's Andrea? Andrea? Honey? Andrea, where's Andrea?
I don't know.
Nothing, absolutely nothing. Get in the car. Come on.
We just got here. Where are we
Dad,
going?
Dad, don't be a stick in the mud. Come on. Get. Move. Come on.
Move.
Let's go.
It better be good.
What's the matter?
Nothing, absolutely nothing. Just get in the car. Come on.
Well, what do you think?
Whose house is this?
Ours.
Yours?
Yeah.
Ours?
Yeah, here. Well, take a look at it.
You got a loan?
Yeah, it finally just came through.
But how did you get it?
Well,
Jean.
Yeah?
How much is this house?
Dad, don't worry. It's all right. Really, it's all right.
In the living room.
And my room is so big, and I even have my own bathroom.
Can we make a fire in the fireplace?
Yeah, we'll get some wood from the back.
Sure, go ahead. Be careful.
Yeah, let's go.
Jeannie, how did you get this loan?
I told him that I'd sell the house and repay the money a year after Ryan dies. Come on inside. It's a really great house.
Is there a guest room?
You bet.
Well, here we go again.
Can't be worse than Kokomo.
Yeah, nothing could be worse than Kokomo.
Don't worry.
You talked to the principal?
Yes, I told you.
What did he say?
He said he talked to the kids. He held a special assembly and told them all about you.
You sure they want me?
Welcome to Hamilton Heights High School, Ryan. Glad to have you with us.
Hi, I'm Jill, student body president.
Hi.
Welcome.
Hi, Ron. Glad to meet you.
Hi, Ron. Hi, Ron.
Hi, Ron.
Hi, Ron.
Hi, Ron.
Hi, Ron.
Hi, Ron.
Hi, Ron.
Hi, Ron.
Picking up the pieces of my
If you need any help or information about AIDS, please call the Center for Disease Control's 24-hour toll-free hotline.
You know, I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm still standing. Made were meant to cut me down. And if my love was just a circus, you'd be a clown.